Okay, so hopefully by now you'll have seen the lathe behind me having been installed. But today we've got the 5-axis and the 3-axis CNC machine coming. Now, later on in the video, I'll get Jason to go over some of the finer details of what these CNC machines can do. But for now, we'll just watch them being installed.
So people often ask me, how on earth do you make a high performance, high quality aircraft at a price point that's not that different to a supercar? And the truth is that it's really never been easier to do that. But fundamentally, the thing that you've got to do is make stuff yourself, you know? Traditionally, aircraft manufacturers have subcontracted a lot of the high value components out to the aerospace supply chain, and the costs get ratcheted up and up and up. Here, we basically use a very traditional model of what we call vertical integration. So if it's expensive, if it's important, if it's a key part of the helicopter, it's made right here. And that's how we get the price down. And the beauty of doing it now in 2021 is that it's never been easier to make high quality precision parts, either in metals or in composites, with a relatively small amount of capital expenditure. So modern CNC machinery means that you can make precision machine components with a very small number of flexible machines that scale very, very well. And those same machines can produce a lot of the tooling that you need to make low-cost composite tools as well. So pretty much everything that you need to make an aircraft, a composite fuselage, rotor systems, and even a gas turbine engine can be done with modern machinery. And so what we've done here at the Development Center, which is a smaller version of what will be in our full production facility, is bring all of that capability in-house, invest in the people, invest in the machinery, invest in the making sure the company has the knowledge to produce these parts. And that's what our take on modern vertical integration is for the production of a helicopter. So if we go and have a look at some of the key pieces of equipment that we've invested in recently, you'll understand how we can make some of these things quite simply in-house. So let's start with our CNC lathe. So if you think of a helicopter or a gas turbine engine, there's lots of components in there that rotate: bearings, gears, shafts, elements of the rotor spindles, flight controls, hydraulic servos. Anything that has an axis of rotation around it will generally start life on a lathe. So this is a machine where you'd stick a piece of stock material in here, it rotates round, and then the tooling will come and cut a revolved pattern out of the material. So for example, if we take how we make gears, then this component here would start as a bar of material that had been cut to length, and then the tooling will come as it spins in the chuck, the tooling will come and cut this pattern out of it. And that's basically how a gear starts life before we then go and cut the teeth into it using one of the other machines that I'll show you in just a second. So when you're producing gears, once you've got your blank, which is your volume of revolution, that then goes onto the 5-axis machine. And this is a machine that essentially allows the milling tool to be positioned in any orientation that you need to cut complex shapes. So the trunnion can rotate, and the table can rotate, and the tool can move in various directions. And that allows us to come and cut things like gear teeth, so we can make precision aerospace grade gears on this simple machine here. We can make our compressors on here. We can dress turbine wheels and nozzles and do finish machining on all of those sorts of components. And we can make bearing races and things like that on here. So this is the most flexible metalworking machine that we have, a very, very capable, very, very high precision machine that allows us to make all the most intricate parts that you'd find within a gas turbine engine or a helicopter. The three-axis machine, which is just over there, is a little bit more, a little simpler. It can only move the tool in three directions, but it has a much bigger bed. So this is the machine that we use to create all of the machine faces on the big components on the helicopter, such as the gearboxes. But most importantly, you can think of this machine as a mother machine. This machine will spend most of its time making tools. So whether it's patterns that we take tools off for the composite components, whether it's aluminium tools or steel tools for the rotor blades, or whether it's intricate bits of machinery, jigs, fixtures, tooling, and the other apparatus you need to build the whole aircraft. The point is, irrespective of what metal it is, or irrespective of what material it is rather, whether it's metal, whether it's composite, or whether it's anything else, we can make it right here. And that's how you drive the cost down in producing a modern high performance light helicopter. So vertical integration for general aviation is a pretty simple idea. You bring the highest quality raw materials in you possibly can through the front door. You add the maximum value to those raw materials in-house, and then you send a premium product out the front door. And that's a very simple idea, but of course, any business has to go on its journey to get to that point. And so over the last few months, we've been procuring the necessary equipment that we require in terms of our CNC machines, in terms of our composites capability, in terms of our metrology equipment, in terms of our casting facilities, to be able to do all of those things in-house. And now here we are. The first wave of that equipment has arrived, has been installed, has been commissioned. And as of now, Hill Helicopters can produce its own precision aerospace grade components to the highest possible standards in-house at the lowest possible price. And that really is the template for everything else that we're gonna do across the program. So vertical integration is really how we deliver these aircraft. It's how we deliver them faster, and it's how we deliver them to the price point. And as of today, that journey's off and running.